Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I'm going to teach you how to do a virtual sound check on your Behringer XR18 or Midas MR18. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident in your production gear no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, on the Behringer XR18, X18, and the Midas MR18, there is an 18-channel USB interface for audio in and audio out. And we have our 16 XLRs on the front of the board, and so we can take those over a USB cable into our computer to record them. And I just posted earlier this week a video on how to actually do the multi-track recording, and if you missed that, there is a link down in the description below, so check that out. But this video is how to get that audio playing back into our mixer so that we can practice mixing. Now, when we are recording the audio in the multi-track portion, we are wanting to make sure that we are recording it at the source, at the analog or the input, where none of our post-processing of our channels are actually affecting that audio. And that is very important if you're wanting to be able to do a virtual sound check at a later time. And again, that is by going into our input and output, going to our USB sends, and making sure that these are set to analog or input. If they're set to any of the other options that are here, the audio will be affected by the settings that you have on your mixer. But if you have it set to analog or input, it is going to just be the raw audio directly after the preamp, which is great, because then when we're doing a virtual sound check, I'm wanting to be able to go ahead and practice mixing or setting adjustments for a new vocalist that I had during rehearsal or something like that. So I want my audio to just go right back into the channel. That way, any of my settings that I'm wanting to adjust, I can. So on our routing page, so our input and output, we can go to USB returns. Now, this is where we can get our audio from our DAW playing back into our mixer. And what we want to do is we want to route our USB input, which is the USB output from our DAW. So our DAW has outputs, and those go to the XAIR mixer as an input, a USB input. So when we're looking at USB input, that's actually the output of our computer. So we want to make sure that my 1 is set to channel 1 and that my 2 is set to channel 2 and go all the way down until we get to channel 16. And then we can see that our USB input 16 is going into our channel 16. Now, once we have that set, we want to go and look at our board, and then we want to go to input, and we want to set all of the channel sources to be USB. And so I'm going to go through one at a time and change all of these channels to be from USB. Now, if you use the arrow over key, you can kind of go through a little bit faster. Oops. There we go. And boom. So now we have all of our channels set to USB here. So any of the audio that's playing from my DAW will go back into the XR18. Now that we have that our audio for the XAIR mixer set to USB, we need to route our audio from our DAW. Now, the DAW that I'm using today in this video is Reaper, but if you're using a different DAW, you'll need to route the audio outputs of every track to the channel that you want on your XAIR mixer. So for instance, Studio One, you would need to route and set up those outputs so that you can route the audio to those individual outputs. Now, all of my channels are mono in this sense, and a stereo channel is still two mono channels that are just linked. So we want to make sure that we have all 16 channels available to be routed if you're setting this up. But in Reaper, all we have to do is go to View, and then we can go to our routing matrix, which is right here. Once you have routing matrix open, we have all of our channel sources right here. So we can see that I have my master output, my kick, kick in, and all my 16 channels that go down. Now, then we can see our destination here is our output. So we can see that we have output 1 through 18, and then we also have our stereo outputs here as well. Now, with my kick out, I want this to go to output 1, and my channel 2 I want this to go to output 2, which again on the mixer is called USB in for actual routing to those channels. So we then have our output 3, and I'm just going to go all the way down and select the corresponding channel to the track. So we can see that I have 1 through 16 all routed here. Now, one tricky thing right here is our master output is currently routed to output 1 stereo, which means it's 1 and 2. So if I was to just press play, the entire mix of my DAW would be going to my channel 1 and 2. Now, if you are utilizing this XAR mixer for recording, my suggestion is to take your master output and route it to your stereo 17, which would then put it on your aux channel on the board. Now, the only other thing that we have to do is we need to delete this routing. So our master output, we need to delete from output 1 and 2, and that way just our kick in and out goes to those channels. Now, if we wanted to hear our master output on our channel 17 and 18, what we'd need to do is we need to go to the board, go to our input and output, make sure that our aux is set to 17 and 18. Once we have that set, then what we can do is we can go select our aux and change this to USB. But currently, I don't want to hear my mix from my DAW, so I'm just going to leave this on analog. Now that we have all of our audio routed, all I have to do is just go ahead and press play. And then at this point, we can go back over to our XAR edit and we can see that we have all of this audio playing on all of these channels. And I can go through and solo up just the kick in, or say the snare top. Now, when I am playing back in this virtual sound check situation, I can go to my kick out and I can go adjust the gate, the EQ, the compression, and all of the settings that I set here, then if I flop back to my input, would be the same. So it is recording at the same level preamp-wise and putting it back into the channel at the same preamp level-wise as if you had that drum set or that singer up on stage recording. So that's why you want to make sure that your recordings are set at the correct preamp level. And then if we need to adjust something, we can see that I have my USB return here. And we want our USB return to be at 0, at nominal, not adding any gain, not subtracting any gain. And that way we are ensuring that the audio that we recorded in our virtual sound check is also playing back at the same volume in our virtual sound check. So we can go through and go ahead and do all of our mixing and settings and do everything that we want to this audio. Now, if you are looking for some audio to play back into your mixer to practice mixing, I do happen to have a set of multi-track downloads that you can find on my website at drewbrashler.com. I've also linked it down in the description below. I recorded a song at a church and had a few little mishaps that I threw in there specifically for you guys to practice mixing audio. So if you want to check that out, you can go check that out. Otherwise, I suggest checking out my other video for multi-track recording. Now, once we have finished our virtual sound check, what we can do is we can go and take our audio back from our inputs. Now, we can go to our kick out and we can go and select our mic line for our inputs. And so we'll go through all of these channels and set them to our mic line or our analog in. Now, once you've done that, we can then go and just verify that we have our audio playing back from our inputs with a mic. Check, 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 check. And let me turn up the master here. Check, check, 1, 2. So now we have our audio playing back from our inputs. And this is an important thing because you don't want the embarrassing portion of you having set your mixer to a digital sound check, a virtual sound check, and then go back to your stage, band comes on, and they have zero audio. And so that's something that can happen. And so just want to make sure that every time you're finished doing a virtual sound check, you go switch back all of your inputs to being on your analog in. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or if there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the XAIR mixer, or really any of the other production mixers that are out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com, where I have those multi-tracks, and I have a new video course specifically on the XAIR and MAIR series mixers. And you can find more about that in the description below. I have a link, or you can go over to drewbrashler.com and find that for yourself. Otherwise, I hope you guys have a great day.